We finally have the crane in place, and the front half of the house is ready to be attached to the lifting cradle. Most of our getting stuck problems are behind us. As in the first three segments, I have speeded up some portions so you can see what is happening without getting too bored. But in this, the final segment, I did leave the actual lifts and setting of the house at regular speed so you can get a sense of how it happened in real time.
They'll take that off when they get over there.
We got a bell still. Look, all the other wheels on.
No, wheels are on there. They keep a watch there. They'll come around. Make sure I'm getting all of this.
Take the wheels off after once it gets in there.
Yeah, I think that probably. I wouldn't say for sure. They're not messing with the hitch at all. I would think that they'd drop that hitch right away. But I don't know. Maybe it throws the balance off or something. I don't know if you got a house like this or not. I've been living down in River Falls, so I haven't really been keeping up on the news.
The house went in there fast. That's why I can't picture being built there.
He quite possibly had gotten a double wide. There's a lot of that going around. They're built so good, you know, in a factory like
many,
that.
Many of them.
And that there's got 2x6 walls in.
All into it.
Yeah.
You're going to put up one hammer in there. Well, you put in a plywood basement. I wish you would have done that.
Oh, yeah, I'll bet he did.
Treat a post of plywood. You should have gone cement.
Yeah. See, that's... And Dad was... Dad checked everything out here. He wanted to make sure that the basement was bone dry. And I told him that one of the best things you can do for that then is to...
Well, he found out that...
Poured basement.
After done it, he found out that lowered the value to be hell because the plywood basement people were scared of.
Oh, I can hardly blame him, you know.
Why wouldn't you treat the timbers well?
I guess no matter how treated the wood is, I sure wouldn't dare go. You know? That's just...
Guys, there's a way to save you, you'd be lost.
My opinion, the only wood that ought to be buried is when it's growing on a tree and that's the roots. put it.
The crane operator told me that sometimes he has to sit there for hours with the house hanging in the air while the contractors rebuild the basement wall to fit the house. This wasn't a problem in our case. The contractor had worked well with the manufacturer to answer the question, exactly what size is that house? The result was that it all fit perfectly.
Kids, don't try this at home. These people are skilled professionals. Just out of curiosity, why are you standing around holding the post?
Well, that's all scraps down on the sangle come on these and tighten up.
Oh, okay.
They're coming in from the ends, the waste distributed there, and it's coming this way.
Okay.
We've got to get some jacket on the rip and catch that material so it doesn't come down to the wall.
That's it.
Well, it appears that after that lift, they're going to have to re-level the crane. It probably sunk in the mud quite a bit. So at this particular point in time, I think I'm going to cut the tape, save the battery, and I'll get back to you as soon as they're done re-leveling the crane. Something with the crane. I'm not sure if that's got to do with re-leveling or not. I suppose we'll watch a little more and see.
Yes, dear?
What did I find?
What did you find? A toad. Hold him right up here.
What?
Hold him right up here. Come here, wait, come here, come here. Come here. Hold your toad so that his little face shows. Whoops.
Okay. Like this?
Yep. There you go. Tasha's got a toad.
side of those beams are going to overlap. Yeah? Let's bring her down slow and see what we got.
I'll ease it down a little wood. Give her the ease almost the same.
Real easy.
You guys are the greatest. You even got it done before it started to rain.
Yet. We got it half capped, huh?
Say what?
Say we don't even have the bands out of there.
And you guys got it half capped? That's fantastic.
Beat the rain.
Thank you. Hey, you guys, I think they started cutting them off at this end.
Got a kink in it, I guess.
Oh, okay.
Are they all pulled in for it? No, they're still working on the handle right now, so this should be it.
like Bob Vila, huh?
There you go.
You never hear anything from his cameraman, but old Bob Vila just runs around and does all his stuff.
He's on the spot.
Yep.
Hey, you got my knife?
Yeah. I think so.
Those just lay down on their own with a little sunshine?
Yeah. We'll check them maybe tomorrow.
Okay, I'll put some black tack under them.
Okay.
We'll get those sealed down. I noticed that side laid down pretty good, right?
Yeah, beautiful.
And the sun was out. Yeah, that way a pair of these wings. It does take a seal down. Well, that worked pretty slick.
Sure did. Everything went really, really well.
A lot of work to it.
Well, you guys really did a bang-up job. I'm...
Never seen one done before?
No, never have. I was just amazed how smooth everything went.
Everybody knows what to do.
You know, it's complex. Everybody knows the next step.
Sure.
The six guys stayed for 3 days while completing the assembly and siding of our new house, while other contractors worked on a breezeway to attach the house to the brown building, install lower level windows, build 2x4 walls in the basement, connect the sewer, etc. We took over from there, wiring in the new house and adding about 600 feet of wiring for the basement alone. Once we completed that wiring, the contractors returned to insulate, sheetrock, and paint the basement walls.
Yeah, we'll see if they need help. They want to load up all this stuff, or they'll never get in there tomorrow if we get a bunch of rain.
Yeah, that's right. Well, what do you think?
I think it's wonderful. And look at the rain held up just the right amount of time. You guys are going to get a little wet though, right?
We've been wet before.
Have you?
Oh, yeah.
I'm so glad.
Once or twice.
And you're not coming out, you promise? Okay, good.
Aren't you going to go in?
Not yet.
Anyway.
Why not?
What's that?
We're kind of dirty anyway.
Oh, are we going to go in? Can we take our shoes off and go in?
I'm sure you can go in if you want to.
Can we go in?
I think so. It's your house. Should be able to.
Probably have to go in the back door, huh, Mom?
I don't know. This one looks like it might work too.
Well, the screws aren't off.
Well, here we are in the new house. It's all put together. Not all put together, but they just got done setting the pieces, as you saw just a minute ago. And now you can see we can go into the bedrooms. Well, those guys will put the door up, sweetie. Well, they are going to pick Dad's tractor up with the crane. This ought to be good.
Whee! This is going to be fun watching them get picked up. They're picking them! Picking!
Don't touch the windows, okay, sweetheart?
Everybody watch out, the kids especially, not to get their fingers in any cracks or on the floors.
On any, say that again.
These cracks here.
Oh.
Cracks on the floor, because if something shifts, it's not in its final position.
Okay.
So they don't go feeling around and stick a finger in there.
Guys, did you hear the guy? Don't stick your fingers in any cracks. Okay?
Don't step on the screens.
Yep. Be careful.
There's bugs in here.
Is this one of the bedrooms?
Yeah, this is...
I'm going to pick them right out.
Uh-oh. What'd they do?
They used the crane to get Dad out of the mud.
Yeah, isn't that cute? Are you taking pictures of that?
Yeah.
What you're doing? That's great.
That was fun. Look at all the
I said that earlier on the tape too when I was sitting down there. I said I wouldn't spend any time digging around my tractor if I had a 150-ton crane at my disposal.
Well, I already said you to pull them off, but the crane picked them up, so.
And away he goes.
back without breaking off?
It's now 23 years later, September of 2015, and we are still very happy with our purchase and with the contractors who did the work.